James, I'm sorry. I don't know where he is. I told him that we were doing it this time. Oh, there he is. Nice of you to join us.
Thank you.
What's going on with the hairdo?
Figured I'd try a new look for my auditions.
Your voiceover auditions that nobody sees you?
Voiceover!
What is it?
In a world, one man and one woman fight for what's right.
Oh, nice. Starting with the classic movie trailer. Look, so we get this question all the time. What is voiceover?
Merriam-Webster hath defined voiceover as...
Oh boy, here we go.
A, the voice of an unseen narrator speaking as in a motion picture or television commercial. And B, the voice of a visible character as in a motion picture expressing unspoken thoughts. There you have it.
No, hold on, wait. Okay, we can explain more than that.
I have spoken.
Okay. When people think of the entertainment industry, they think of acting in movies and TV shows, but VO is a huge part of it.
And you don't need to be in Hollywood or in New York to do it. You can be anywhere now. Voiceover is everywhere. Watch till the end to see us put together an actual voiceover spot you'd see on TV to help further explain what voiceover actually is.
So let's go down the list of genres within the world of voiceover. Commercial.
Animation, anime, cartoons, etc.
Narration.
Audiobooks.
Promo.
Trailer.
ADR or automated dialogue replacement and looping.
Video games.
Radio imaging.
E-learning, instructional and educational.
Announcements like PA announcements in airports, train depots, and more.
IVR, which is phone messaging, and there's a whole lot more. You can see there's a ton of different options, and with those options come a ton of opportunities. But there's a catch, and we'll get to that in a sec.
You may be someone who never even thought about this until now, and you decided, I'll do a search.
Or maybe you're someone who's got hundreds of characters in the back of their brain, you're chomping at the bit, trying to figure out how to put them to use and make some money.
Or at some point, someone may have told you that you have a great voice, so you should get into voiceover. That's what he did. Know what? That is a great start.
But it won't get you gigs.
Well, it could.
Well, yeah, absolutely. It could if you know someone personally who needs a voice for their project or their commercial, if they work at an agency, but no agent's just going to walk down the street and say, here you go. Of course, we can't say that, you know, all this never happens.
Yeah. But we're talking about if you want to do this part-time with the goal of making voiceover a full-time career, which is doable.
Yeah, if you want a long and sustainable career, the catch that we were talking about earlier, here it is. It takes training. It takes acting. It takes learning how to control your instrument, your voice.
We say this in our classes over and over again, just so we get it in all of our brains. Voiceover is a craft to learn, just like acting. You know when you've seen bad acting, right?
That happens in voiceover too. So yeah. Training is a must.
And at the same time that you train, you need to make sure that you're learning how to take direction. In our classes, it happens automatically because you get in the booth every week.
But what do we mean by taking direction?
Well, when you book a job, the time that you end up recording is called a session. And in those sessions, producers and creatives and oftentimes the client will all be in a room listening to your voice.
Your voice. So let me take the real life example. I've done many campaigns for my favorite glasses company, Warby Parker, over the past few years. When I'm in a session with them on, say, a 15-second spot, there are only 3 or 4 sentences in there.
The script is easy to read and understand, but when you're recording, you're not simply reading. You have to communicate the message, which is much different than reading words on a page.
Let's take the genre of commercial for this example. You have to connect with the person listening, which could be a regular person just sitting in their car or watching TV listening. You can't come across as reading because that's just boring.
You have to connect with them and make them feel like you're talking directly to them. How do you do that?
And then, there's the technical side. Can you warm up the read? What does that even mean? Can you go up on this word and then end down at the end of the sentence, but make sure that you put a smile on this word and pause right after that?
It sounds like a lot, but with training, you can learn it rather quickly if you're serious about learning. And the more quality training you get, the easier it will become, and you'll be on your way to becoming a true professional.
Being a VO talent means you're your own boss. You'll be an entrepreneur owning your own small business, and you'll also be your own marketing person, accountant, engineer, because you have to record and edit yourself, and a whole lot more.
Now that you know all these different genres within the voiceover world and a little bit more about what's involved, how are you feeling? I'm not gonna lie, it does take work.
But it is so rewarding, and you're putting everything into yourself. Just taking those first few steps are huge. And if you want free help, we have a ton of videos on this channel just for you.
But if you want to get started right now, we run the Atlanta VoiceOver Studio and ProVoiceOverTraining.com to help people like you get started in their journey to becoming a full-time talent.
Our goal is to equip, elevate, and inspire, and we've been doing it for years. The key is by taking it in bite-sized chunks.
Hundreds of people have come through our studio and learned the craft and are off on their own voiceover journey. And because we know how daunting it is and all the questions that come up, we've got a process of steps that make it easy.
If you know you're ready and you want to let us help you in this exciting field, then you can always get started with our on-demand Intro to VO workshop at provoiceovertraining.com, where the steps are laid out step by step for you.
Or if you're in Georgia, well, come in person to the Atlanta VoiceOver Studio and take it there, or wherever you are. If you want to join live classes but you're not in Atlanta, you can also join live via Zoom.
All the info is online at atlantavoiceoverstudio.com.
Just let us know if we can help you in your journey, and we'll be cheering you on.
And to go further into voiceover, in our next video, we'll talk more about how to get into voiceover, what steps to take. Thanks for watching. All right, so what does the process of creating a voiceover commercial look like? I'm going to simplify this process for the sake of brevity and because the creative process varies from agency to agency, national to local. Now, when I was in radio as a copywriter, the salesperson would have a client they'd meet with, get all the pertinent information, and depending on what they got, I'd either have a list of bullet points that the client would want in their copy or a whole page. And this can be the difference between national and local. Radio stations can be so focused on the bottom line that they're not willing to inform the client that copywriters can be trained, and often are, and know how to get people to respond just because they want to please the client initially, even though the end result might be junk that doesn't get people to do what their call to action is. So the client ends up adding in what they think is important, and copywriters just have to basically plug in information into a script. And often, clients then wonder why their ads don't work. It's the way it goes. Now, national ad agencies have years of experience and data supporting why the creative they come up with would work and set them apart. And clients understand this, even though there are most likely discussions and compromises taken. In my opinion, I think creativity wins more in national spots over local most of the time. Side note, if you're interested in copywriting and advertising, look up Roy H. Williams, aka the Wizard of Ads. Dude's a genius, and he's got a great Monday morning newsletter. So back to my local writing. After the salesperson would give me bullet points or info about the client or company, I'd craft a commercial to include what they wanted and tried to make it interesting to listen to for the audience instead of just pelting would-be listeners with stats and information and a call to action at the end that would just end up boring them. And therein lies the challenge of creating commercials, making it interesting enough for people to keep listening or watching, in the case of TV commercials, without tuning out. Once the script was written, I'd take it to the production director at the radio station and he'd figure out what voices would be needed. Sometimes they'd use me, sometimes they'd use another on-air talent, or anyone who could actually do a semi-decent job at voice acting. Oftentimes, it was another salesperson or the person at the front desk. Another side note and tip, if you are a voice talent who's just beginning, go to your local radio station and offer your voice to the production or creative services director, the person who produces the station's commercials. If it's a smaller station, the program director will be the one to talk to because they're most likely wearing multiple hats, but otherwise it would be a production director. But offer your services, and in lieu of payment, because radio stations are cheap and they don't pay, ask the production director or whoever your contact is to send you a copy of the spot you voice. You can use it as a sample of what you can do to sell yourself to potential clients you may be trying to get, and you'll end up replacing that with your professionally produced demo, which you will need if you're wanting to get agents. You'll replace it with that down the road, but it's good to use in the meantime. And I have to say this, because some will have missed it, always continue to train, because voiceover is a craft. If you think you've arrived, but you're not making a living at this, you've not arrived. And even when you're making a full-time living, continue to train. You're still on a journey. This is a craft. You can only get better and better, as we all are trying to do. Now, we can always improve. And like we always say, the trends change, so you gotta stay up to date. Now, once the production director records the voiceover for the spot, then they go to work producing and adding music and sound effects and whatever else they need. We had this salesperson who'd always want to comment on the spot, and he'd ask, "Hey, can you start the spot out with an interesting sound so listeners' ears pipe up and they'll listen?" Didn't matter that the sound wouldn't actually make sense for the spot, he just wanted the sound effect. What are you gonna do? Radio. After the production director is done producing, they'd most likely play the spot back for the salesperson and then to the client, so the client could sign off on it, and then it would go to air. As for TV, the process is similar in local areas. Writing process, once they have a good structure for their dialogue, they storyboard their visuals, figure out where the spot's going, and then they shoot the video portion of the commercial. The footage gets sent off to an editor to cut together, and once they have a rough cut, if local, they'll most likely use a music service they subscribe to get the music bed. If it's a bigger agency, they may even hire a composer to write the music. Oftentimes, engineers in big studios are also musicians, and they know how to create something. I've known some amazing musician engineers, and it just boggled my mind how creative and talented they were. It really is something to be seen, because they'll just whip something up. And they just work away in the studio as an unsung but well-paid hero of many, if not most, commercials. If the commercial has voiceover, the ad agency will have already contacted their favorite VO or acting agencies and have those agents send out talent auditions. The VO agents might have been told that they only want their top 10 talent, and if that's the case, that's what's sent back to the ad agency after those auditions come in. The agency may decide on the talent to use, or they might bring in the client to make that decision. Sometimes you just want to make those decisions yourself as an ad agency, especially if the client trusts you. If you have a client with numerous people having input, it's so much tougher to get approval. As we always say, too many cooks in the kitchen. So once they find their voiceover talent, hopefully that's you, you'll be brought into a studio to record, or if your home studio is good enough, you'll record from your home studio. You'll be directed this way and that, and when they're happy with your final performance, everything gets massaged together and you end up with a final product. There are nuances to any creative project, and like I said, it depends. So for the example we're about to show, we pulled some stock footage from Storyblocks, and I gave James some direction about what I wanted to show. Then I wrote a script around it. Typically, it may work in reverse, but for this example, that's just how we did it. Then after I wrote it, I tweaked it according to what I thought would work best. Then I recorded the voiceover. After that, James put it all together, moved my voiceover around to where it made sense, and it came out like this.
Does your everyday life look like this, externally or internally? Are you in control? Or does your day just seem to slip away? Maybe it's time to give yourself permission to get away, rest, and recalibrate. Visit one of our country's national parks this summer and get some perspective. Book now at gimmeabreakcauseisureneedone.com.
Now, don't judge. I just threw it together in about 5 minutes, but it gives you an example of how it all comes together in case you've never seen that before. So now you know the quick overview of how a commercial is created. Check out some of our other videos if you'd like to learn more about voiceover. And if you want to take classes in person or via Zoom, go to atlantavoiceoverstudio.com, or you can do it on demand at provoiceovertraining.com. We have links in the description box too. Thanks, and we'll see you on the next one.